everyone. Want to put a quick update together on the bonsai and what's going on with the fishing side of it also. Well, I guess we'll start off with the big boy, the beast. That's a sycamore. And right now I'm using it for a clothesline to dry my bass and bonsai hat off. Now, I just wrote that on there, but I was kind of wanting to see what it looked like. And you guys can, you know, let me know what your thoughts are. Should I just leave the, you know, logo onto the side? Or I thought about having a bass and bonsai added on one other side or somewhere else on the hat, maybe across the back. I don't know. And I guess we'll start from one end to the other. This is the one I still got to do. Has nothing done to it yet. Just bought it from the nursery, set it over here. It actually looks pretty cool just sitting there like it is. Here's this one. I still do not know for sure what kind of trees these two are. It's actually growing pretty good. You can see it's going to have some pretty crazy buds popping out up here. I don't know how high I'll leave it. It's only about a foot tall with that sticking up, so I may leave it like that and do something. Now these are just a couple cuttings that came off the Rhode Island Red Japanese maple that look like they're going to make it fine to be a whole separate little trees. And then this is nothing. Just a bunch of four-leaf clovers. You guys, well, three-leaf. You guys see any four-leaves in there? That's who, this here's a wisteria. You got future plans for that. The other two things that haven't done anything are these two stumps here I cut out. I haven't seen any life out of those yet. They could just be late bloomers, we'll see. And then this thing that I thought I couldn't kill, so I cut it back hard. I thought it was just a weed. It's actually, it's still alive, but I think I did a little damage to it. Then we'll just finish off with these little guys here. There's my first one I potted up this year. The one I just did in that last video you seen. This guy's one of my first wiring jobs. He's about ready to go through a redo as soon as I think the root system is good enough, you know, where I won't tear it up trying to restyle that tree. Him and the other one are going to be restyled. And here's the ficus tree. And it won't need anything for quite a while. That's just a chunk of deadwood I found sitting out. There's also a couple other pieces of driftwood, deadwood, whatever, that were just sitting around places I was out trying to look for bonsai trees. Here's the beaver. This is what I've kind of nicknamed a wild thing. It's just kind of going wild. It's actually, it's hard to make out maybe, but it kind of has a windswept look going already. Everything's leaning to the right. The branches have kind of been grown to the right. There's a few sticking to the left. I could just chop them off and leave it like a windswept look possibility. I'll pan out just real quick. The ones out here are just actually full-size trees that I've got to cut down, but this is the Birch River clump is what it's called, but it's not really a clump, it's just a tree. And as you, I'll give you a quick, it'll probably be, I'll chop it here, and then somewhere probably here, and then this will be your main leader, and then I'll turn these into, you know, smaller branches, and I think that'll make a good little tree. The wisteria actually has a good kind of a trunk going already. So I'll get to it before long. Then that is the Japanese maple, Rhode Island Red. Of course, I don't know why that didn't stay red for long. You can see those little cuttings. They're still red, but this thing pretty much as soon as they pop out, they're kind of red and then they just instantly turn green once they get any size to them. Of course, it's not looking too bad right at the moment. It looks fairly healthy. I see the video where I cut it back once already this year. Then that's the cross. This is kind of, I'm still working on the top. You can see that when I cut it, all those little places are doing what I had said, that, you know, they go on from much longer, I'll be cutting that back again, and then it'll go from two, then there'll be four. And this is kind of just a, like I'd mentioned, practice tree on top, because the possibility that all that will be chopped down eventually to go, you know, cut down in that area, make for a shorter tree, because that's so lumpy right there in the middle. Then we come over here to what I'd been worried about, another one. The stump has actually come to life pretty good. You can see there are several little buds there. At the top is popping out pretty good there. So it's still alive, and that is probably going to make for a pretty cool bonsai tree once the, you know, I get the top foliage going good. Then there's another, that one of the first ones I've actually did any wiring on. It's going to need some work later on. There's this guy. Well, there's the other one I just finished. That was just that quick $5 bonsai deal. I actually ended up with two bonsais. I did use a little $2 pot, so $7 and two little small bonsai trees. That's about as cheap as you're going to find them doing it yourself. Then this guy, I'll give you a side shot. You guys may know why, but from looking at him like that, I nicknamed this one Woody. And then this guy, I don't think is going to make it. I don't think I had enough, had this weird thing where it was growing. It's a big lump, but I don't think there's enough roots in there to, I don't know. I still haven't given up. I'm going to let it, you know, just sit there until it looks like it's dried up and not growing. And then this little one, can't tell, there's a bud there. Let me see if we can get to it. Right there. And I don't know if it's gonna pop out or not. And then the last one, this is the one I've got probably the most promising as far as being a very cool bonsai tree. It's got this gnarly trunk going into the nabari, the root system. And I don't know if you can make it out. I call this one the hand, kind of for two reasons. Well, basically because it looks like it has two hands. This would be your left hand. And I'm going to let this one. This would have been a kind of high up for a thumb. Somebody had already cut it. But I luckily, right where it needed to be, one of the first ones to pop out on back budding was this guy. I'm going to let it grow out and just grow, and, you know, until it's this tall, almost starting to. It's the only one I'm not going to cut. And I'll cut all this stuff back. This is basically the shape of your hand right here. It's got the four fingers. This will be the thumb. And, you know, from this side, I've showed it before, this is like the palm of your hand. But then what's also cool, now I may be making a stretch, but this part reminds me of a hand also, like digging into the ground. If you guys can see what I'm talking about, like there would be my thumb, you know, the top of your thumb digging in. I would need to cover that just a hair because it almost looks like it's splitting again. But then this would be your first part of your fingers, you know. So that, to me, from a certain angle, if you guys can see it, looks like a hand grabbing in, holding on to the soil, and then this hand's reaching up for the sky. So, I don't know. I think that'll make a cool looking tree. Once it, you know, it's going to need to grow out. That, once I get it planted, just depending on how I, and I may do that first to where I can get these looking the way I want them, almost just the way they are now, to where it's grabbing hold of something. And then I'll start styling this, and I've already got a few ideas. Maybe you guys could help me, tell me what you think, because this, the only downside to this being a hand is, you can tell, that's your pinky finger. That thing's huge. That's like almost the biggest one. It's not the biggest. This is the biggest. This one, which should be the actual biggest, I can still make it the longest, you know, if you just look at your hand. But, well, my hands are almost all the, not too much difference. So this one will definitely need chopped down shorter. This one, you know, you're just like your hand. It's pretty simple to do. You just look at your hand. The middle finger will be the longest. This one down shorter. This one down a little shorter, but almost as long as your middle finger. And then I know what some of you are thinking, because I thought it too. Well, why not just chop the other three down a lot bring the foliage in, leave this one up, and it's almost like you're giving the finger with the hand. That would kind of be just a thought, but possibility. It's all in the way I decide I want to style this thing. We figured out kind of what the trees are. Some of them I've even named, nicknamed, whatever. But also, like I said, I'm working on the GoPros. I've got two of them right now. I plan on getting a third. I've got a remote. I know how to work the remote now, but the problem is when I do the 5-minute thing, and maybe some of you guys could help me out with this. I took it, it's on a 5-minute loop. It records for 5 minutes and then it shuts off. Or basically after 5 minutes, it's recording. If I don't hit the button, then that means it's gonna basically re-record over itself. It's gonna erase those 5 minutes and start back over. What I'm having happen is that I let it go past 5 minutes, like 5 minutes and 20 seconds, and I hit the button. And it one of them gives me the first minute of the 5 minutes before that, and the other one just keeps going. I don't know, I still gotta work on it. But they're stopped, and then I hit it again to start over. So it's kind of getting a little frustrating. To what you're watching on now, this little phone, I've kind of gotten used to it and I know how to go in there. The problem with it is just the amount of memory it'll hold. So, and the GoPros give a little broader look on everything when you're out fishing. You know, you can see everything just a little bit more, but they still kind of suck. Like, I wish I had a kind, and I probably need to invest in one, the ability to zoom out, because there's spots where I know, like, okay, I'm going to have a hit there, you know, I'm casting along the bank. I'd like to actually have a camera zoomed in on that for some topwater stuff I'm going to try to get. So we're still working on all that. But real quick, I want to show you a little bit of GoPro footage I did get. This is, and we'll watch this and come back, but this is me at the little test pond over here, kind of testing out the GoPro stuff, the reel I just picked up, and just seeing if they were hitting on topwater. So watch that and we'll be back. Oh, you're not watching that? Well, watch that. We'll be back. You're watching it now? You're still not watching. Watch the clip and then come back and I'll see you. Bye. Hey everybody, GoPros are here. We're at the test pond. We're actually testing this and what view it's going to give out, and not really testing this. I've already used it once, but I'm going to do a little topwater. I'm hoping to get a little topwater bite going on here. So anyway, like always, wish me luck. I got him, kids. Did you see him? He just kind of sucked it in. Wasn't really a good topwater bite. But it's a bass. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's a good one. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Just something told me it will be hitting topwater. Good old lucky mega bass in my favorite color of Top Max. And as you can see, I don't know, pound and a half maybe. Not a monster. Look how fat it is. I don't know if that thing's getting ready to spawn or not. Of course, I'm a mile up here, so I'm going to have to give it a little toss out there. All right. All right. Okay, I caught a bass, yeah. It wasn't that big. I only caught one that day. That test pond's like one or two bass only. And it's like murky. It's kind of nasty, though. They're probably all moving, you know, somewhere else a little further south. But then we also had Hicklin fishing. I didn't go. I don't spoonbill. I don't do the snagging and all that stuff. But I'll show you a real quick shot of, this is my son, Norman, who I call brother. I know, it's weird. Then Matt, you've seen in all the different videos, and his son Jaden are down, I can't remember, Osage, something. They're down south fishing for spoonbill, which is, you're kind of just snagging, you're casting. Any of you guys don't know about that, you're just basically, I ain't going into all that. So anyway, they're down there fishing for spoonbill, and this is just a quick clip of Jaden attempting to reel one in on his own. I think they had to you know, stop and help him. And then a shot of him with his fish, but watch that too.
It's hard, it's a big fish.
Okay, so as you see, they catch multiple species and all that kind of stuff. I'm kind of a just catch bass and release. I'll catch the occasional crappie. I'll look nice crappie. And I'll eat crappie. Somebody volunteers to, hey, you bring them back. I'll clean them and cook them. I'm going crappie fishing. We're going to, you know, hit the stop button on bass fishing, go crappie fishing. But as of yet, I haven't found anybody to do that yet. A lot more fishing coming, a lot more bonsai coming. I will tell you real quick, I plan on going on the bonsai. I plan on, now the nurseries are stocking up with their stuff, I'm going to go pick up some cool different junipers and stuff. That Walmart one was just kind of a quick little, oh wow, $5. I'll tell you, I'll do something with it, show them how cheap you can get into bonsai with. But try to find a little bit bigger ones to start with. I don't really like starting with the ones that small. My eyesight for one thing, and for another thing, they just take them a while for that trunk to develop into a good looking trunk. You can find some $30 to $50 area shrubs that you can turn into a cool looking bonsai tree right off the bat. Anyway, like, subscribe, and thanks for watching.